Good morning, children. Today we are going to learn about chapter 4, topic Life Mathematics. Under this topic, you are going to learn about the concept of percentage, profit, loss, and simple interest, and the problems involving percentage, applications of percentage in profit, loss, overhead expenses, discount, and GST. And you are going to learn about the compound interest and to find the compound interest through patterns and formula and use them in simple problems, and to find the difference between compound interest and simple interest for 2 years and 3 years, and to recall direct and inverse proportions, and to know about compound variation and do problems on it, and to solve time and work problems. So these are the concept, that is the learning objectives in this chapter. So the first topic based on the percentage. Applications of percentage in word problems. We know that percent means per hundred or out of hundred. Okay, it is denoted by the symbol, that percentage symbol. The x percentage denoted the fraction x divided by 100. Children, the percent, you know that percent means it is out of 100. So the x percentage can be denoted as x by 100. For example, 3% means it denotes 3 divided by 100. Okay. Now let us move on to some examples based on the percentage. Listen, children, the first question, first example sum. If x percentage of 600 is 450, then find the value of x. Already I told you the x percentage of 600. X percentage can be written as x divided by 100. Half means it is multiplication. So x divided by 100 into 600 equal to 450. You can cancel the 100 and 600 by 6 times. 106 are 600. So you can cancel 100 and 600. 6 you will get. Then bring that 6 down to the denominator in the after equal to sign. So 450 divided by 6. If you divide, you will get the value of x is 75. Okay, now let us move on to the second problem. When a number is decreased by 25%, it becomes 120. Find the number. Decreased means already you know that decreased means it is denotes minus symbol. Increased means it is denoted by the symbol plus. Okay. Now let us move on to the solution, children. Solution. Let the number of x given. The number is decreased by 25%. So you can take, now we have assumed the number be x. So you can write x minus 25%, that can be written as 25 divided by 100 into x, which is equal to, it becomes 20, that is given in the question. So you can write which is equal to 20. Now in the next step, you take 100 as an LCM. So you'll be getting, you have to multiply the 100 with the x. So you'll be getting 100x minus 25x divided by 100 equal to 120. Next step, you subtract the 100x minus 25x. So you will be getting 100 minus 25, what you will get? 75. So 75x divided by 100 equal to 120. Now keep the x as it is. Take the other term to that side. So 120, the denominator 100 will go that side. When it go that side, it changes into the numerator part. So 120 into 100 divided by 75. You just do the simple calculation, that is you simplify it. You will get the answer x is equal to 160. And you can do this problem by using the another formula method, the allator, the at the side they are given. Another method can be used, but you by using the formula, that is the d is equal to 1 minus x divided by 100 into a. You can apply this formula also. Okay, now let us move on to the next problem. Example 4.3. Akila scored 80% of marks in an examination. If her score was 576 marks, then find the maximum marks of the examination. You have to find the maximum marks. Solution. Let the maximum mark be x. We don't know how much marks Akila scored. Okay. So let us assume that maximum mark be X. So 80% marks in an examination. So you can write 80% of X is equal to 576. So 80 divided by 100 into X is equal to 576. This implies X is equal to 576 into 100 divided by 80. On simplification, you will be getting 720 marks. So therefore, the maximum marks of the examination equal to 720. Okay. Now let's we will move on to example 4.4. Example 4.4. If the price of the Ore doll after 20% increase is rupees 96 per kg, then find the original price of the Ore doll per kg. Per kg it means 1 kg. The 1 kg cost how much we have to find. That is the original price. Solution. Let the original price of the Ore doll be rupees X. New price after 20% increase. Increase denote the symbol plus, already explained to you. Decrease means it denotes minus symbol. Here it is given 20% of increase. So you can write X plus 20 divided by 100 into X. The next step, you take LCM. So 100 into X, 100X plus 20X. That can be written as 120X divided by 100. And in the question, it is given 20% increase is rupees 96 per kg. That means which is equal to 96. So 120X divided by 100 equal to 96. So X is equal to 96 into 100 divided by 120. 0, 0 will get cancelled and 12 you cancel by 8 times. 12, 8s are 96. Multiply it, you will get 8 into 10. Rupees 80 is your answer. So therefore, original price of Ore doll per kg, X is equal to rupees 80. You can use the another formula, that is using aliter means, that is another method. By using this formula, you can do. That is, I is equal to 1 plus X divided by 100 into A. This formula also can be applicable. Okay. Now let us move on to the exercise problem, children. Exercise 4.1. So you will be having the first one, fill in the blanks. Okay, first one, fill in the blanks, subdivision 1. If 30% of X is 150, then X is dash 30% of X. So already explained, the percentage can be written as what? 30 divided by 100. So given 30% of X is 150, that is 30 divided by 100 into X equal to 150. Now we have to move on to the simplification. So X is equal to 150 into 100 divided by 30. When 30 by 100, when comes this side, that is after equal to, it get changes. The numerator and the denominator part will get changes. So you will be getting 150 into 100 divided by 30. Now we have to go for the simplification. So 150 and 30 will get cancelled. 30, 150 will cancel by 5 times. 35 is 150. Now multiply 5 into 100. You therefore the X value is 500. If 30% of X is 150, then X is 500. That is your final answer. Okay. Now let us move on to the problem number 2. Subdivision 2. 2 minutes is dash to 1 hour. So solution, let 2 minutes be X percentage of an hour. We don't know what is the percentage. So we are going to assume X percentage of an hour. So 1 hour equal to how many minutes, children? 60 minutes. So 1 hour equal to 60 minutes. Here they had given X percentage and 2 minutes. So you can write X percentage equal to 2 divided by 60 into 100. So 2 into 100 you will be getting 200 divided by 60. You cancel 1010. So you will be getting 2 times you can cancel. You will be getting 10 divided by 3, which is equal to 3 1 by 3. Let us find how you are getting 3 1 by 3. So 10 divided by 3. So you will be getting 3 3s are 9. Again the balance will be 1. So you can write it as a mixed fraction, 3 1 divided by 3. That is your quotient, remainder and the dividend. You can write 3 1 by 3. So X percentage is equal to 3 1 by 3 percentage. So therefore 2 minutes is 3 1 by 3 percentage to 1 hour. That is your final answer. Okay. Now let us move on to subdivision 3. If x percentage of x is equal to 25, then x is equal to dash. Solution, given that x percentage of x is 25. So x percentage, that can be written as x divided by 100 into x, which is equal to 25. Now multiply x into x, you will be getting x square, which is equal to 25. Bring the take that 100 to that side. So 25 into 100, you will be getting 2500. Since x square is 2500, means x is equal to, you can write root of 2500. So x is equal to root of 2500. So the root of 2500, if you multiply x is equal to 50 into 50, you will be getting 2500. So that your answer is x is equal to 50. Okay. So if x percentage of x is equal to 25, then x is equal to 50 is your answer. Now next we'll move on to subdivision 4. In a school of 1400 students, in a school of 1400 students, there are 420 girls. The percentage of boys in the school is, so we have to find the percentage of boys in the school. I'll repeat the question, children, once again. In a school of 1400 students, that means in a school there are 1400 students are there. In that, 420 students are girls. Okay, we have to find the percentage of boys in the school. Okay, solution, given that total number of students in the school is equal to 1400. Number of girls in the school is equal to 420. How will you find the number of boys children? Yes, absolutely. You have to subtract from your total number the girls and the total number of students. So you can subtract to find the number of boys, 1400 minus 420, subtracting the number of girls from the total number of students we are going to subtract. So your answer is 980. So number of boys in the school is 980. Now in the question, they ask you to find the percentage. They didn't ask you to find the number of boys, but they ask you to find the percentage. So let us find the percentage of boys in school equal to number of boys divided by total number of students into 100. Okay, so what is the number of boys? 980 divided by 1400 into 100. Cancel two zeros, two zeros. Okay, so you'll be getting 980 divided by 14. So which is equal to 70 is your answer. So therefore, the percentage of boys in the school is 70% is your final answer. Okay, now let us move on to the subdivision 5. 0.5252 is dash percentage. Okay, we want to find the percentage of 0.5252. Solution, to express 0.5252 as a percentage, we should multiply it by 100. Okay, so when you multiply it by 100, you will get the percentage. So to express as a percentage, we should multiply it by 100. So 0.5252 into 100 is equal to, when you multiply this number, the point will come after two numbers, that is 52.52%. So 0.5252 is 52.52%. Now let us move on to the second Roman letter, that is the second sum. Rewrite each underlined part using percentage language. So we have to write the underlined part as a percentage, that is in the percentage language we have to write. Okay, question number 1. One half of the cake is distributed to the children. One half. So the one half means that is nothing but 1 by 2. Okay, so you can write one half solution, that is 1 by 2 into 100. So you cancel 2 and 100 by 50. So your answer is 50%. So therefore, 50% of the cake is distributed to the children. Okay. Now let us move on to subdivision 2. Aparna scored 7.5 points out of 10 in a competition. Let us find the solution for this. 7.5 points out of 10 is, out of 10, she scored 7.5. So you can write it as a fraction, 7.5 divided by 10. So when you divide, the point will come before. When you multiply, the point will come after the number. When you divide, the point will come before 7. So your answer is 0.75. Now they ask you to find the percentage. So what should we have to do? The before sum I taught you, what do you have to do? You have to multiply it by 100. So 0.4 percentage, we need to multiply it by 100. So therefore 0.75 into 100, which is equal to 75%. So therefore Aparna scored 75% in a competition. Now let us move on to subdivision 3. The statue was made of pure silver. So pure means it was 100%. Okay, 100% it is made up of silver. We want to write it in a percentage thing. Okay. Solution. Pure silver means there are no other metals combined. So no other like a copper or any other metals. It is not a combined. Only it is made up of pure silver. So 100 out of 100 parts, that is made up of silver. 100 divided by 100. So to express as a percentage, 100 divided by 100 into 100%. You can cancel and under 100. So your answer will be 100%. So therefore the statue was made of 100% of silver. Pure means it is of what? 100% of silver. Now next let us move on to subdivision 4. 48 out of 50 students participated in sports. 48 out of 50. How will you write? 48 in the numerator part and 50 in the denominator part. So 48 out of 50. Solution. Fraction form of 48 out of 50 is 48 divided by 50. As a percentage, we need to multiply it by 100. So 48 divided by 50 into 100. 50 you can cancel by 2 times. 50 and 100 will get cancelled by 2 times. So 48 into 2, you will be getting 96%. Okay. So therefore, 96% of students participated in sports. That is your final answer. Now let us move on to subdivision 5. Only 2% out of 3 will be selected in the interview. Interview. Only 2% out of 3 will be selected in the interview. Solution. Fraction form of 2 out of 3 is 2 divided by 3. As percentage, we need to multiply it by 100. So 2 divided by 3 into 100, which is equal to 200 divided by 3. So you'll be getting 66.2 divided by 3%. Let us see how we are getting 66.2 by 3. Let us do the division. 200 divided by 3. 200 divided by 3. How many times you can cancel? 3, 6 are 18. Again, you can divide it by 3, 6 are 18. The 20 balance we will get. That is 20 minus 18 will get 2. And bring that 0 down. Again, you can multiply 3, 6 are 18. You will get the balance will be 2. Okay, so you can write it as 66.2 divided by 3%. So therefore, only 66.2 divided by 3% persons will be selected in the interview. Okay. Now let us move on to the problem number 3. 48 is 32% of which number? So 48 is 32% of which number they asked. Okay, solution. Let the required number be x we will take. We assume that the required number be x. Okay, so given that 32% of x is 48. So the percentage can be written as what? 32 divided by 100 into x, which is equal to 48. So you can write x is equal to 48 into 100 divided by 32. That is nothing, but you can simplify. The 48 and 32 will get cancelled in 8 table. Okay, 6 8s are 48 and 8 4s are, that is, sorry children, 4 8s are 32. So you'll be getting 6 in the numerator part, the denominator for 4. Again, you can cancel 6 and 4 by 2 table. You can cancel 6 and 4 by 2 table. That is 3 2s are 6 and 2 2s are 4. Now you multiply 3 into 100, 300 and denominator part 2. So you can cancel 300 by 2. You will be getting 150. Okay, so therefore the x value is now 150. Now let us move on to problem number 4. What is the 25% of 30% of 400? So you have to find both the thing, that is 25% of 30% of 400. Let us find first 30% of 400. Then with the answer, you have to find the 25%. Okay. Now let us move on to the solution. So first 30% of 400. The 30% can be written as 30 divided by 100 into 400. 100 4 times you cancel. So you will be getting 4 into 30, 120. Same 25% of the above is 25 divided by 100 into 120, which is equal to 30. Okay, so you can cancel 25 and 100 by 4 tables. Okay, 25 ones are and 4. Again, 4 will get cancelled by 3. That is, 4 30s are 120. So your final answer will be 30. And the before sum, the 30% of 400 also like that. 100 you can cancel 4 times. 4 into 30, you will be getting 120. Okay. Thank you, children. Today's session is over. We'll see the balance sum in next class. Okay.